Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta. This is our first lecture on class 12, chapter 5. The name of the chapter 5 is matrices continuum. As its name suggests to us, matrices continuum means we have to do focus continuum on our matrices. It means we have to learn different properties and different concepts related to our matrices. So before to start the video, I request those students who still not watched my previous video, please watch that videos, because we did already explain different concepts and different properties related to our matrices, and this topic is going to be based on our previous lectures. So please make a look here. I am taking our first topic, which is adjoint. Firstly, we have to know learn what is adjoint. Adjoint basically a matrix which is obtained by taking transpose of the matrices of a cofactor. I again repeat the statement of the adjoint. Adjoint basically a matrices or which is obtained from by taking a transpose of the cofactor matrix. It means firstly we have to take or make a matrix of the cofactor elements. Then our second step, we have to take its transpose. So we got a matrix, and that matrix is called adjoint. So it's very simple, because we already know how we calculate the cofactor elements and how we prepare our cofactor matrix. So make a look here. Adjoint is basically represented by notations is ADJ. ADJ basically adjoints, and we have to write inside the name of the matrices. For A, you have a given matrix A is equal to, so it means the name of the matrices is A. So you have to write in close brackets. So this is a notation for adjoints. Our first question or the first concept is adjoint. So that's why I'm taking our first question of exercise 5.1, element mathematics. Find the adjoint of the following matrices. Our matrices is 1, 2, 3 and minus 5. What does it mean? We have to calculate the adjoint matrices. In this we have to first calculate the cofactor elements. That's why I am writing the cofactor elements. Cofactor of our first element is A1, but it means first row and first column. Our first row and first column is here 1. It means we are calculating the cofactor of our first element is 1, and you have to cut the element that rows as well as that column containing this element. It means we have to cut this first row and first column. We get only minus 5. So please write here, this is minus 5. Now we have to calculate the cofactor of A12. A12 means your first row and second column. It means we are finding the cofactor for the elements 2. If we cut this column and this row, we get the elements 3. Now we have to find the cofactor of elements 2, 1. It means second row and first column. It means we are finding the cofactor of elements 3. What we will get, if we cut this row and this column, we get the element 2. Similarly, we have to find the cofactor of A22. A22 means second row and second column. For the cofactor elements minus 5, we get the elements 1. But in this, we still get the minor, not the cofactor. We have to take its sign to get the cofactor, and what's the sign of these elements. So I again revise, and you have to add rows and column. If the number is after a sum of row and column, you get a number. If number is an odd, you means you have to change the sign, and if you get the number is even, you take the sign as it is. It means first 1 plus 1, it means 2. 2 is even. Even means we have not changed the sign. So we get the same answer. Now, 1 plus 2, 3, which is odd. Odd means we have to change the sign. This sign is positive. So we get the sign negative. Now again, 2 plus 1, 3. Again odd. We have to change the sign. Now sign is plus 2. So we change the sign. Minus 2. Now 2 plus 2 which is equal to 4 which is even. So we cannot change the sign. The sign is 1. So it will be as it is. So we get in this manner the cofactor of our elements this. Now put it into the their corresponding position. Cofactor matrix. We obtained our cofactor matrix. First element's cofactor is minus 5. Second cofactor element is minus 3. Third cofactor element is minus 2. Fourth cofactor element is 1. So we get this is our cofactor matrix. But our question asks us find the adjoint. Adjoint means we have to take its transpose. So what's an adjoint? Adjoint means cofactor matrix is transpose, and we already did what's the transpose. We have to change the row into column, which is very simple. So in this our first row is minus 5 and minus 3. We have to change it into column. We get minus 5, minus 3. This is our second row, minus 2 and 1. We have to change it column. So it becomes our column, minus 2 and 1. This is our final answer. So please make a note first. I hope this question will be clear to you. So our desired answer is this. So this is the basic concept that we are discuss here. Now, if such question put up in your final exam, then you have to do in this manner. But if such question will be put in your competitive exam, then how you will do? It can be done within your 1 second. 1 second means if you find our order of matrices 2 into 2 and you have to calculate the adjoint, you can do it in only 1 second. 1 second means it's very easy. What's the trick? Here we have to calculate the adjoint of this. This is your matrices. How we calculate is as simple adjoint of A is very simple. How? Please make a note here. You have to change these elements. You have to interchange. You have to interchange these elements. And what we will got? We got minus 5 and 1. We did interchange. Now the remaining elements you have to write on the same position but different sign. It means here is plus 2, you have to write minus 2. Here is plus 3, you have to write minus. Please make up here. Quite easy. I again repeat the concept. It's very easy. You have to interchange the diagonal elements. Here minus 5 goes to this position and 1 goes to this position. And the remaining elements you have to write as it is. But you have to change the sign. In this we have sign positive, so we get the sign negative. Here the sign is positive, we get the sign negative. This is the quickest way. I hope this concept will be clear to you. You can do it in only in 1 second. This is basically a trick for your competitive exam. So please make a note here. I am taking another part, so for our practice purpose, our second part is also find out to adjoint of the matrices, and this is our matrices. For short trick, what will be the its adjoint? You can write in 1 second. What is? We have to interchange these elements. What's the elements? 1 minus x and 1 plus x. We interchange these elements. And the remaining elements we have to do same but change the sign. If we change the sign, what we will get? 1 minus x. If we change the sign, minus x square. This is our final answer. But if we have to do in our exam purpose, but how we do? First, cofactor of a11. a11 means x plus 1. If we cut this row and this column, we get 1 minus x. Now we have to find the cofactor of a11 means x minus 1. If we cut this row and this column, we get x square. If we have to calculate a21, if we cut this row and this column, we get x minus 1. Now if we have to find out the cofactor of a22, we have to cut this row and this column. But we will quote, we got x plus 1. Now again the way, 1 plus 1 even, even means the sign is same. 1 plus 2 odd, odd means we have to change the sign, negative. 2 plus 1 3 odd, we have to change the sign. 2 plus 2 4, it means we have not to change the sign, x plus 1. So our final answer is 1 minus x. I am writing cofactor matrix, 1 minus x minus x square. If I multiply this, minus x plus 1, means I get 1 minus x, and this is change the elements 1 plus x. X plus 1 or 1 plus x is the same. Now what's the adjoint? Adjoint means cofactor matrix, and we have to take its transpose. Then what's the transpose? It means we have to change first row as a first column, 1 minus x minus x. Now our second row is this, we have to change it into column, 1 minus x and 1 plus x. Now look at this, same. So please make a note first. Now I am going to take our next question. Please make a note first. Our question number second. The third part of the question 1, you have to do it yourself because it is same. I am going to take our second question, first part. In this we have to find out the adjoint of the matrices, which is in terms of 3 cross 3 order. So firstly we have to calculate the cofactor. So I am writing this for the cofactor. How we calculate the cofactor? The process is same. I am taking our cofactor of first row and first column. It means we have to eliminate first row and first column. What we will got remaining? If we cut this first column and first row, we get only these elements. 3 minus 2, 0, minus 1. Please wait a just minute. So we have to remove first row and first column. We got 3 minus 2, 0 and 1. So solve this. We have already know we have to do cross multiplication because it's basically a 2 cross 2 determinant. 3 into 1, which is equal to 3. 0 into minus 2, which is 0. It means we get 3. And change the sign. 1 plus 1, even. It means the answer will be same. Now for A12, first row, second column. First row, second column, we get 2, 2, minus 2, 1. Now solve this, 2 into 1, 2, minus 2 into minus 2, minus 4, so it becomes 4, which is equal to 6. Now 1 plus 2, 3 means odd, and change the sign, so we get negative 6. Now do same here for our A13, third row, first column means we get 2 into 0. Please write here 2, 3, 2, 0. 2 into 0, 0, minus 2 into 3, 6. We get minus 6. And 1 plus 3, 4. It means the sign will be same because we get even. Now do same step. A21, second row, first column. We get minus 1, 0, 0, 1. Now solve this, 1 into minus 1, minus 1, minus 0. It means we get minus 1. 2 plus 1, 3, odd. So we have to change the sign. So our sign is plus 1. Now our second A22. To change second row and second column, we get 1, 2, 0, 1. Now solve this. 1 into 1, 1, minus 2 into 0, 0, we get 1. Now 2 plus 2, 4, it means even we have to take sign same as it is. Now we have to calculate A2, 3. Second row, third column, we get 1 minus 1, 2 into 0. 0 into 1, 0, minus 2 into minus 1, it means 2, we get 2. And 2 plus 3 is 5, means odd, we have to change the sign. So we have sign is negative 2. Now solve this A3, 1. Third row, first column, we get minus 1, 0, 3, 2. Solve this, 2 into minus 1, minus 2. 3 into 0, 0, we get minus 2. 3 plus 1, 4, even so, the sign is same. A3, 2. Third row, second column, we get 1, 2, 0, 2. Now solve this, 2 into 1, 2, minus 0, it means we get 2. 3 plus 2, 5, odd, odd means we have to change the sign. So we get minus 2. Now solve A3, 3. Third row and third column, we get 1, 2, 1, 2, minus 1, 3. Now solve this, 3 into 1, 3, minus 2 into minus 2, minus 2, it means we get positive. Answer is 5. 3 plus 3, 6, even, so the sign remains same. So these are the cofactors of each element. Please make a note first. So please make a correction here, because I removed the sign here. Negative. This is the sign of negative. So in some step, I take the sign positive. So in this, we have to take some new corrections here. 3, 1. If we take third row and first column, we get minus 1, 3, 0 and minus 2. 0 and minus 2. It means we have to do minus 2 into minus 1 plus 2. So we get an answer here is positive 2. Now same is here. We get 3, 2. Third row and second column, we get 1, 2, 0, minus 2. So what we got? Minus 2 into 1, minus 2, minus 0, we get minus 2. Now change the sign. So we get the positive 2, because 3 plus 2 is 5, or we have to change the sign. So please do make this correction. Now all the elements are same. So firstly we have to put our cofactor matrix. Our first element is 3, second element is minus 6, third element is minus 6. First element is minus 4, this is plus 1, second is also 1, and third one is minus 2. And these are the last, is 2, 2 and 5. We obtained the cofactor matrix. Now we have to obtain the adjoints. Adjoint means we have to take transpose. This is our cofactor matrix. And if we take transpose, this is our first row, then it becomes 3 minus 6 minus 6. Second row is 1, 1 minus 2. Third row is 2, 2, 5. This is our final answer. So please make a note first. Now the question has three parts, second part and third part. So these two parts you have to do it yourself. Now I am taking our third question. We say if A is this matrix, verify that A into adjoint of A, if you multiply A with adjoint of A, which is same as if you multiply the order, change adjoint of A into A. You already know the multiplication of the matrix is not commutative. It means if we multiply A into B, it is not maybe possible. So we get the same matrices as if we change the order B into A. I again revise, A into B, B into A. In the case of the matrices is not possible. It may be for some case, but every time is not possible. But in this case, if we change the order A into adjoint of A, we change adjoint of A into A, the result will be same. This is the property. and this is basically your question, but actually it is your property. So this property, keep it in mind, because on basis of this property, 1 marks question will be asked in your final exam, which is same as if we calculate the determinant of the given matrices and multiply by the identity matrices. So please make a note here. So this is not your question, it is basically your property 1. Now we have to do verifications, but I am going to take it shortcut, but you have to do in your fair notebook in a complete way according to your examination point of view, but I am solving by using a shortcut method by verification of this result. Firstly, I have to calculate the HOT. I am taking A is our matrices is equal to 5 minus 2, 3 minus 2. Then what will be the its adjoint? By shortcut trick, we have to interchange the elements. It means we get minus 2, 5. And the remaining elements we have to remain as it is, but we have to change its sign. So we get here positive 2 and here we get negative 3. This is our adjoint. Now also we have to calculate its determinant, because in this question determinant is also used. So what's the determinant of A? If we solve this here, what's the determinant of A is? It's very simple, cross multiplication. 5 into minus 2, which is equal to minus 10, minus 2 into 3, minus 6, it means plus 6, we get minus 4 again. 5 into 2, minus 10, and 3 into minus 2, minus 6, and minus minus plus 6, so we get minus 4. Now put all these values and calculate or verify our result for our property. So firstly we have to write A. A is what? A is your 5, 3, minus 2, minus 2. Now adjoint of A. Adjoint of A is minus 2, minus 3, plus 2, plus 5, which is must be same. Adjoint of A, adjoint of A is minus 2, minus 3, plus 2, 5. Now multiply A. What is A? 5 minus 2, 3 minus 2. Now we have to please make a note first, then I will rub this portion. Please make a note first. Now putting it is equal to determinant of A is minus 4, and what is I? I is identity matrix, and 2 is, this is basically 2 cross 2 matrix, then what will be 1 0 0 1. Now we have to solve this and prove these sides. Now solve this, we have to do multiply 5 into minus 2 minus 10 plus minus 2 into minus 3 plus 6. Now 5 into 2 10, minus 2 into 5, 10. Now do 3 into minus 2, minus 6. Minus 2 minus 3, plus 6. 3 into 2, 6. Minus 2 into 5, minus 10, which is equal to, go multiply, minus 2 into 5, minus 10. 2 into 3, 6. Minus 2 into minus 2, 4. 2 into minus 2, minus 4. Minus 3 into 5, minus 15. 5 into 3, 15, minus 3 into minus 2, 6, 5 into minus 2, minus 10, and we have to multiply minus 4 to each element, but we get minus 4, 0, 0, minus 4. Now solve this, minus 10 plus 6, minus 4, and please make a note here, we multiply these elements, 5 into 2, 10, and minus 2 into 5, this is minus 10. So we get here 0, minus 6 plus 6, 0, 6 minus 10, minus 4, minus 10 plus 6, minus 4, this one is 0, this one is 0, 6 minus 10, minus 4, which is same as minus 4, 0, 0, minus 4. It means it's broke. So this question is very simple. You have to do in this manner and you can calculate or you can prove any identity. So please make a note first. Now I am going to take our next question, question number 4. We have given A is this matrices, B is this matrices, and we have to verify that adjoints of multiplications of AB is equal to same as result if you multiply adjoint of B into adjoint of A. I already explained a property in case of transpose. What the property is? If we take A, B transpose, then the order of the transpose is changed. We solve the bracket. We get B transpose into A transpose. Same here. If you want to take adjoints of A, B, then the order of the adjoints will be changed. Adjoint of B into adjoint of A. Now this is your second property. So please make a note here. Now we have to verify it. So that's why we have to do first multiplications of A. So I am doing here A into B. What is A? 1, 2, 3, 5. What is B? 2, 0, 1, 5. Now you have to do multiply. Now 1 into 2 we get 2. 2 into 1 we get 2. 1 into 0, 0 plus. 2 into 5, 10. 3 into 2, 6 plus. 5 into 1, 5. 3 into 0, 0. 5 into 5, 20. 5. So now again not 2 plus 2, 4. 6 plus 5, 11. 0 plus 10, 10. 0 plus 25, 25. What we will go? This is our A into B. Now we have to calculate B and A. I am using a shortcut method for proof, but you have to do a proper method. Now I am taking out adjoints of AB. What's the AB matrices is 4, 10, 11, 25. Now we have to take adjoint of B. What is adjoint of B is 2, 0, 1, 5 into adjoint of A. What is A is 1, 2, 3, 5. Now I am using shortcut tricks. What's the result? The order of the elements is changed. It means we get 25, 4, and the remaining elements signs will change. So we get minus 10, minus 11. Now same here, these elements are interchanged. 5, 2. And the sign of 0 is negative, is also 0. So we get here minus 1 into 5 and 1 are interchanged, 5, 1. And the sign will change, minus 2, minus 3. So multiply this, we have to take as it is. Solve this, 5 into 5, 25, 0 into minus 3, 0. 5 into minus 2, minus 10, 0 into 1, 0. Minus 1 into 5, minus 5, 2 into minus 3, minus 6. Minus 1 into minus 2, we get 2, 2 into 1, 2. This is our left hand side. Now if we solve this, what we will get? 25, minus 10, minus 11, and 4. It means left hand side is equal to right hand side, and this becomes proof. That's why I say these portions are very very simple. So please make a note and note also each property at your first place before to start the exercise portions. Please make a note. Now I am going to take our question number 8. Before the question number 8, all the questions are same. So you can do it yourself because I have already explained a concept of each question that you can do easily at your self. Now our question number 8, what it state? It said a square matrix A of order 3. It means we have a matrix of order 3 cross 3. We have also a determinants of that matrix is equal to 5, and we have to find A into adjoint of A. It means we have to find the adjoint of A, and for finding the adjoint of A you will have to need the matrices. But here the no matrices is given. It means this question cannot be done by directly, because this question is basically based on your properties, and this question is very very important. That's why I'm right here, very very important, because such type of question, property based question, must be put as a one marks question in your final exam as well as in your competitive exam. This question is very easy, but you have to keep it in mind its property. But it's the property. Look at this. What we have? We have a determinant of the matrix is 5. And what is the order? Order is represented by n. It means we have n is equal to 3. What we have to calculate? We have to find A into adjoint of A determinants. So look at this property. Which property? Compare this property. Look at this, A into adjoint of A determinants. So this is directly, if we multiply A into adjoint of A, and then we will take its determinant, which is same as determinant raised to the power n. So this is equal to determinants of raised to the power n. And what is the value of determinant? It is 5. It means 5 raised to the power 3. And we get 125. This is your final answer. This is your also one second question. It's very important, and all these property based question will put in your final exam. So please note all these properties. Now please look at this question. This is question number 17 from your NCERT. The same question asked in the NCERT. If A be a non-singular square matrix, non-singular means the determinant of the matrix is not equal to 0. If the determinant of the matrix is equal to 0, that matrix is called singular matrix. It means we have a matrix which is non-singular of order 3 into 3. Order gives the values of n. It means we have n is equal to 3. Then we have to find the adjoint of A, and we know what's the determinant of adjoint of A. Which property? Our property third. Adjoint of A determinant is equal to determinant of A raised to the power n minus 1. It means raised to the power, which is equal to determinant of A raised to the power n minus 1. So what's the determinant of A in the option? The determinant of A is same, so we have to put A determinant as it is. What's the value of A? N 3 minus 1. So we get A raised to the power 3 minus 1. 2. It means the answer is your 2. So make a note first. So today we complete do our exercise 5.1 from the element mathematics. And if you are reading the NCERT, then we did exercise 4.4. And the exercise 4.4 has two parts. First part is adjoint and second part is inverse. We complete only the adjoint, which is our exercise 5.1 from your element mathematics, and the second part of exercise 4.4 from the NCERT is inverse, and the inverse exercise is based on our exercise 5.2, which is our next exercise. So we will start with our next video. So if you like my video really, then you can subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. And please do subscribe and like, and to maximum share with your friends. I will try my level best and try to prepare one video for each class, 8th class, 9th class, 10th, 11th, 12th, and take step by step our next exercise. So I try to plan to cover the whole syllabus. After that I will cover our competitive exams as well as the final exams. 1 marks question, 2 marks question, your final exam, most important question, and so on. So for watching my video from start to end, I really thank you. Please comment me on my YouTube channel if you want to know about the next exercise, or please you do subscribe so that you can get notifications whenever I upload a next video. And if you have another question that you have problem, so you can WhatsApp me on my WhatsApp number is 9671632413, and you can also mail me by gaurav6gaurav6.gupta@gmail.com. And please I request do comments, because I am always read my comments and try to improve my video according to your comments. See you again, then I will take another video.